CTDX, CTDX, CTDX. This is Havana calling. CTDX, CTDX, CTDX. This is Radio Havana calling all shortwave listeners and radio amateurs. Welcome to... DXers Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communication.
Hi, mis amigos radio aficionados all around the world now listening via shortwave and also by means of the streaming audio from www.radiohc.cu coming to you at different times of the UTC day. I'm your host, Arnie Coro, radio amateur CO2JK, now ready to start the middle of the week program of your favorite radio hobby show, DXers Unlimited. And here is item one. You and I monitoring the high frequency bands would easily find out the low solar activity continues to limit the chances of shortwave propagation frequencies above 20 MHz or so, even during the best times of the day at any given location. I'm talking about ionospheric propagation via the F and F2 layers. The exception comes, of course, when sporadic E-layer openings move the maximum usable frequency even well up past the 25 MHz frequency range. As a matter of fact, on a super E-skip opening, the maximum usable frequency may soar as high as the 222 MHz amateur band, and several yet to be properly documented reports. 70 centimeter band signals heard at short bursts during a very intense sporadic E-layer opening some years ago. This past weekend, I heard several 2 meter bands from the beaches that reached Havana from the Gulf of Mexico coast of state. And I can assure you that there was not a minimum chance of a tropospheric group opening in progress at that time. So, if you want to see the region by coming activity in the industrial antenna from the ionosphere, certainly not via a surface wave tropospheric dust event. Observations confirm that solar cycle 24 continues to show very weak activity as compared with any of the previous 5 solar cycles after the number of months have elapsed. I always do my best to answer them as soon as possible. Yes, amigos, every day the email brings in most interesting questions from listeners all around the world, like for example the one sent by Julian from Maryland, Yucatan, Mexico, the listening globally to the 6,000 kilohertz frequency in English. Julian is asking why it is not possible for him in Maryland, Yucatan, Mexico to pick up more stations from other countries in the Americas besides Cuba, Brazil, and sometimes also Bolivia. After trying a radio frequency amplifier stage back in Cuba, according to some reports coming from Argentina. Well, amigo Julian, first of all, let me tell you that at this moment there are just a few stations on the air. From 3.5 to 29.7 MHz, It's quite a challenge, to say the least. That's a big problem. City dwellers, especially those who live in apartment buildings like this building, face a great challenge when trying to live in a small village. The severe restrictions in force nowadays regarding the installation of external antennas and any type of in parallel with the 6 meter dipole, got less of contact and only from the same direction. Very rare in this nuclear solar activity, very low solar activity, very poor propagation condition for long distance earth contact on 10 meters. Although, along the month of June and July, we will certainly enjoy working many times on 6 meter and we are being intensely ionized of the heat layer of the atmosphere. So here is why I have that right thing to you. Go ahead and do a contact short cycle and then look into the next layer of growth at that will make possible to operate on the 2017 and 15 milligrams with relative efficiency and also on the 13 to 14 milligrams. We will use the value of balance to imbalance 1-to-1 drop band transformers at the 6th of the antenna. The coils are built for each band carefully for switching from 20 to 15 meters or to 10 meters in both the loading coils using each entity work with stainless steel blocks, pressure washers and nuts to change the coil. You'll have to work with that. Hand tools, it works very well, and it's the terminal thing that can be done and be done many times. The antenna is adjusted to perfectly well into a slightly less than 15 feet horizontal plate, and when first we are tightly measured in the one dominant using the wide range antenna unit, has proven to provide excellent results. Perfect antenna, 1 meter mounted of this simple antenna, the support is just coming start in a couple of minutes when you want to operate or listen to the radio, and likewise it can be taken down and placed in storage to our friendly or dominant in just a couple of minutes. By the way, it also works on the shortwave band from 19 meters to 13 meters. The good efficiency of this antenna design is actually the unique of the careful built high-q loading coil and the nicely built web design and loading sliders. The two loading sliders are built using 8 wires that are carefully soldered to a circle made of 6 millimeters or about a quarter of an inch of ceiling. They look very nice. Central incubator supports a 1-to-1 balance transformer, and the antenna itself with a short length of RG213 or RG8X quarter wave. So far, all of our customers have reported that the antenna appears that it will work quite well with a simple antenna unit, making possible to operate on the 20, 17, and 15 meters max, of course, when they are open. And if you want to learn more about this compact antenna system, specially designed for apartment dwellers like your city, just send me an email to info@rhc@email.cu. Again, info@rhc@email.cu. And now, the show, the good news. The Unicode of DXers Unlimited high frequency propagation update and forecast. we're in progress, I mean, right now. Except many sporadic UFOs to become more and more frequent all along the end of May, the last 2 days of May, and also all over the month of June. And please don't forget to send us in the reports and comments about this and other public tutorials to info rfc.com.org.
And that's all for today. This is Arnie Cuoto, Radio Amateur 302KK, your host here at Radio Havana, DXers Unlimited, saying 73 and very good to you.
DXers Unlimited with Arnie Cuoto, heard every Tuesday here on Radio Havana Cuba, also on Sunday on RAC.